Now here's a quick look at the flash business headlines from overseas. AI darling NVIDIA, now the world's most valuable semiconductor firm after hitting $3 trillion market cap, the first computer chip company to do so. The shares of the company rallying 147% this year, closing at a record high on Wednesday. This is the first time since 2002 that NVIDIA was worth more than Apple Inc. Still on tech, ASML set to ship its latest chip-making machine to Taiwan Semiconductor this year. This comes months after Intel received the $380 million high NA Extreme Ultraviolet machine from the company. ASML is the world's only manufacturer of the Extreme Ultraviolet lithography technology, and demand for its product is a litmus test for the sector's trajectory. Meanwhile, Amazon's robo-taxi unit Zoox plans to start testing its autonomous vehicles outside the Western U.S. Zoox eyes to deploy its test fleet of retrofitted Toyota Highlanders with human safety drivers in Austin, Texas, and Miami, making its total public testing locations 5, following San Francisco, Las Vegas, and Seattle. Moving on, Latin American e-commerce giant Mercado Libre expects its investments in Brazil to exceed its initial estimate of $4.35 billion this year. It also expects to hire 11,000 workers, up from previous estimates of 6,500. The company cites its strong first quarter growth for its rosy outlook. On to more news, hundreds of thousands of Walmart's hourly store workers in the U.S. in for a financial bonus of up to $1,000 a year. The move follows the January bonus redesign for Walmart's U.S. store managers, allowing them to earn an annual bonus that's up to 200% of their salary. And American Airlines also offering a 17% wage increase for its flight attendants. The move comes after a union of flight attendants warned of a strike after negotiations for a pay raise failed last month. American's flight attendants have complained they've not had a pay raise in over 5 years. And finally, Japan's fertility rate once again dropping to a record low. The nationwide figure declined to 1.2 last year, 0.06% lower than 2022. Japan's population has been declining for 8 consecutive years and is expected to further drop in the coming decades, posing a challenge for the world's most elderly country. A mobile application created to curb illegal and unregulated phishing was launched by the Philippine government on Wednesday, aptly called Fish Shields. It is, according to the Philippine Fisheries Bureau, equipped with digital tools that will help enforcers identify and apprehend cases of unregulated fishing and other violations within Philippine waters, including the disputed West Philippine Sea. Fish Shields, which was developed in partnership with the United States Agency for International Development, can also receive reports of illegal fishing without the internet, helping authorities respond swiftly.
Sir, parang yan yung 911 ng...
Parang ganon. It's a mobile application. In fact, hindi siya kailang online eh. Offline siya, pwede siyang maiba to. And then matatanggap ng isang personnel o law enforcer. And then from there, magkakaroon ng coordination doon sa local government unit to have that real-time response to an incident of illegal phishing.